Hi there everyone. Today I've got a really good demonstration for you using Microsoft Forms, and upon completion of that form it will trigger my Power Automate. Using one of the responses from the form, I will then perform a lookup on a SharePoint list in order to retrieve an email address. I'll then use the information from both the form and the lookup to update a secondary list. So if we start quickly with my Microsoft form, I ask two questions. One, who is your manager? And it's with this information that I'll look up the corresponding email address for this individual. Two, for the demo, I'm asking what sort of accessory would you like to order? If we then jump onto my first list, I have my manager list, which is the one I'm going to use as a lookup. I'll take the name of the manager, perform a lookup, and retrieve an email address. My second list is where I confirm the order that's been placed. I'll input the manager's email, which I'll retrieve from the first list as part of the Power Automate Get Items lookup, the email address for the employee as a result of the email from completing the form, and the accessory, which is one of the answers from the form. And then further to that, I'll send an email just to confirm that the whole process is completed. So into the Power Automate, I'm using when a new response is submitted, and I've picked the form ID for the form that I've already created. Then I must get those response details, and I use a response ID from the when a response is submitted trigger. Then I move on to the get items action. I select the SharePoint site and the list, and then I perform a filter lookup. Now here I've used manager, which is the name of the column in my first list, equals, and then in single inverted commas, I have used the dynamic content, what is your manager, which is one of the answers from my original form. Now I'm sending an email to the manager just to let them know that a form has been completed and an employee has requested a new computer accessory. You'll notice here that I have a built expression, and the reason for this is if you were to drop the email address from get items as it was into the to column here, it would expect an array to be returned, and therefore it would put this whole action into an apply to each. So using this clever little expression here that I've built up, you'll note that I've got a zero here in the square brackets. What that basically tells the expression is to return the first item within the element, or the first email within this element here, and there's no need for an apply to each. If you want to use an apply to each, that's fine, no problem with it, but this is the most efficient way of doing it. And then finally, onto the create item, I get the second list orders, I put in a title, and then again I retrieve the manager's email, which is based on this expression above, the responder's email, and the computer accessory. So hopefully you followed that, and let's give it a go. So onto the test, I will put it onto the manual mode here, and I'll jump onto my form. So I'm going to choose myself as the manager, and I'm going to order a monitor. So I hit submit, and now we're waiting for the flow to run in the background here. So there we go, it's picked up, everything has run fine. If we jump into the email, you'll see that I have my email here to say the form has been completed, requesting a new monitor. And if we go to the orders list, you can see my email address has been put in, the name of the employee that filled out the form, and also the accessory. So that was a whistle-stop tour. I hope you enjoyed it. If you'd like to see more, please like and subscribe. Thank you.